Hey guys, what's going on? So today I'm going to call it, I actually called it closer to 10:30, 10:15. I was getting a little sloppy today. You know, there's a lot of penny stocks that were jumping up. So I was using more shares, 1-2,000 shares because the stocks were priced a little bit cheaper. So taking 400 shares of a 40-cent stock doesn't really make any sense. That would be like a $180 investment or something. It didn't make any sense. So I was kind of trading outside of my zone today, and then I was taking too much size. I was kind of sloppy today, so I was green. We can see here the P&L. I was pretty green. I made 196 or 250 Canadian, which is good. What's today? 196. 250 Canadian. So you're not, some of you might not believe me, but I actually slept in again yesterday. So Memorial Day here in Canada, Memorial Day Canada is Victoria Day Canada. So I thought that Victoria Day weekend was the holiday for the U.S. market, right? So Monday on the 21st, yesterday, I slept in. My other job that I work, we also had a holiday, so didn't work that. I was out, you know, shooting off fireworks with my friends. I slept in, and then I woke up at around 11 when some of the traders were doing their recaps, and I was like, oh shit, I missed a trading day. The holiday... Excuse me. The holiday is next Monday. So, two shortened weeks. I swear to God, I've missed so many days. But anyways, so let's just jump right into this video and see how the trading went for the first bit of today. Hey guys, so I'm watching a bunch of stocks pre-market. I'm not exactly sure which one I want to trade. SNES made a huge move yesterday from like 40 cents here. 35 cents all the way up to $1.30, and they're sitting at 150 right now, so I don't know. There's that one. CHEK is flagging nicely, and also BLNK is popping up. I'm not entirely sure which one it's gonna be. SNES continuation is most likely. The highs are 158. So, I think I'm gonna watch this one for a scalp over 158 into the 160s maybe. I'll probably take double size because it's a lower price stock. Here comes the open, so we'll see what happens. Over 155, I'd take it.
Order yep. Partially filled.
I'm in.
Order filled. Order partially filled. Order cancelled.
Trying to get in, trying to get out. That was...
Order filled.
That was a little messy, to be honest. I don't know, it was kind of heavy, so I had to get out. BLNK makes it over. Okay. If check breaks through this wall,
order
yep.
Partially filled.
I'm in check.
Order filled.
Oh, that was a mistake.
Order filled.
Oh, I'm out of check for a quick, very quick loss. Oh, that sucks. That was a 25 cent loss in 8 seconds. That was not fun. Let's just chill and wait for something good. Buy SNES on a dip. I'm not chasing this though. Filled down here near 162 would be nice.
Order filled.
Got it. 160. Oh, that was 166. It's not terrible.
Order partially filled.
Here we go.
Order filled.
One minute candle is going to make a new high here, 171.
Order cancelled.
About to break. Come on, keep breaking. Break 174. I want to see a little bit more. I want to see the 180s. 169 average right now.
Order partially filled.
Trying to get out 179 there. And I'm all out for now. It's getting a little overextended. The volume is dropping off hard here. So see the decreasing volume. So I think that was the best. I don't think it'll break 180 here, or it'll just barely break it. And then we should have a dip. And then we'll look for something else. I took much bigger size on that. I was pretty confident in that setup. I meant to buy on the dip, not on the way up. And I could have had a bigger winner, but you know, that happens sometimes. Yeah, see, this is the dip I was talking about. It's coming after this decreasing volume here. So I went on to make another couple trades here. I lost again on check. I thought we were going to make a red to green move because a lot of these stocks recently have been doing that. Let me turn down this a little bit. So I thought that would work, but it didn't, and I made the loss a little bit bigger. You can see here I got in for it. And when I tried to jump out, it actually went down 10 cents. So for my entry at 495, I thought we were just going to break through here. The 495 was the break of the 9 moving average here as we were riding the 20. But then unfortunately it sold off and I had to sell out at 87. That wasn't too bad of a trade in itself. It just didn't work. So a lot of the penny stocks here are the ones making the moves, not the typical small caps that I would trade. So again, I was just kind of out of my wheelhouse here. I was trading. I took SNES for a break of the highs. I took another trade on it. So I'm in here with 1,000 shares, a little bit less risk than last time. Instantly, we're up in the 80s. And then I sell once we push through 88 because I see that it's kind of heavy. The stocks behave really weird because someone will randomly pop up with like a 40,000 share bid. And then there's walls of like 50,000 shares that just get bought up like that. But then there's not a lot of follow through, and then it goes back down a bit, and then we shoot forward. So I'm not really used to trading these setups. So I take 2,000 shares of this stock, a much, much lower price stock. I would usually not trade a stock that's only a dollar. So, but these are the ones that are moving. So yesterday, SNES is the one that moved 300%. It started at 30 cents and then made it all the way up to $1.50 or something after hours. So I'm in for the break of a dollar with this one, and I'm trying to sell. Where am I selling here? Let's look at where I sell. I sell at 104, locked up 50 bucks, sold it some more at 107, locked another 25, and then I think we push one more time. Yeah, one more time, and I sell at 112, 112, and finally, I think 112. Yeah, so 109 on that name, you know, not bad. I think I was just taking, I don't even think I was taking too much size. REG, I remember I took a lot of shares twice. It was like 3,500 on a stock that was, 39 cents. And then here I'm selling up in the 40 cents. I don't like the way these stocks react. So I'm going to be careful tomorrow because I went from green on the day following my rules to having a big loser on check, to taking more size. I don't know if it was to make up for it, because like I said, I'm not going to take 400 shares on a 40 cent stock or a dollar stock, because $400, I know this month and Trader Rehab is about discipline, but I'm also trying to keep the percent gain like in the same kind of range. Like if I make 10 cents, I'm expecting to make $30, $40, $50 or so. So if I... a stock that's 42 cents will not make a 10 cent move. It will make, what did I buy in here? 4 cents of a move, 3 cents. So within 3 cents, I have to capture the same amount of profit usually as, 10 cents. So anyways, I just don't like trading these, so I called it a day, a really good day actually, the best day of rehab so far, but that's only because of the bigger size. Like, so I feel good about today, but maybe not the best. It was kind of sloppy, but I do have to expand the amount of stocks that I trade or how I trade them. So with that, I think we might be done. Unless we're going to do a live trade here on LMFA, but I doubt it because it already made its 1 minute pullback twice. So I don't think I'll trade this. I got to call it a day. I don't want to screw up the profit. So you guys have a great day. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you like the channel. Ask me any questions in the comments. I always answer all the comments that people leave or questions or just any sort of replies. So anyways, we'll be back to trading tomorrow. Have a good one.